to our podcast. We are again here with another podcast. As we all know, because he was in the last podcast, he is unable to host that. So today's podcast is about two matches. First match, Chennai and RCB. It's Chennai Super Kings and Royal Challengers Bangalore. And the next match on 23rd March, which is of between the KKR and Sunrisers Hyderabad. So Abhinu, please can you put some light on the first match, the Chennai Super Kings and RCB?
There is a high chance of CSK winning this match because against RCB, the two teams have clashed 31 times, of which 20 times CSK won, 10 times RCB won, and one was not decided yet. So I think CSK has better chance to win this match, as of what their team is very good, their powerful team. They have the opener Srinivas Gaikwad and Finn Allen. I think he will come to the CSK squad, and followed by Ajinkya Rahane in the middle order with Moeen Ali as a spinner, and of course Dhoni as the captain of CSK in 2024 with the most powerful all-rounder and of course the greatest spinner of all time, Ravindra Jadeja. And following it, the pace bowling lineup of Mukesh Chaudhary, Mathisha Pathirana and Deepak Chahar, of course Shardul Thakur as an all-rounder in the middle order. And whereas I think RCB cannot win this match because I think their bowling lineup is so weak, because they have no recognized bowlers. Only Mohammad Siraj is the only bowler who can do well, but sometimes he gets very economical. But I think they have not bought many players, good players actually. They have not targeted the good players. So they have got this Mitchell Starc, Rhys Stokley, Riyaz Dahl and Lockie Ferguson. Lockie Ferguson is not a good player, because last year when Lockie Ferguson was in GT, he was not a good bowler.
Extremely sorry, Urdu. Lockie Ferguson was not in GT. Last year Lockie Ferguson was in KKR and he was extremely good. And previous to that, Lockie Ferguson was in GT.
Sorry, I was just wrong with first. But their batting lineup is very powerful, of course, no doubt. Because starting by Clive Du Plessis, opening by Virat Kohli, after that Cameron Green, Rajat Pathidar, and of course the Glenn Maxwell, it's our 360 degree player, of course I can say, you can do. And followed by Cameron Green, William Jacks, who can bowl well, speed. So I think there is a chance of winning. Both teams will collect. No one can say who will get. But the real fact is that we are going to see the greatest clash between our two best players, that is Virat Kohli and Mahendra Singh Dhoni. Hopefully we know that this is the last time we will see both of them in the field at the same time. We will be enjoying a lot in this match, I think so. Every fans will be delighted to see this match. And let's talk.
Actually, I think about the RCB squad, the biggest mistake is choosing Azhari Joseph as the foreign fast bowler, and with the inclusion of Lockie Ferguson, because both the bowlers are very expensive in their recent times and their performances are not that much good in T20 at least. So in the wide ball cricket, you have to take a good bowler having less economy and who will take more wickets, right? So I think this is the weakest point of the RCB team, but except that, they have the strongest batting lineup. Maxwell, Virat Kohli and many more.
Yes, I think they have done a wrong thing in an option, that players like new players like Gerald Coyle in the World Cup and big players, Mitchell Starc, they didn't go up to 21 crores. After that they left it, and they don't want Gerald Coyle. The thing is that they are not the smartest buys. They have got the wrong bowlers, I think so. Because they have chances to got the good bowlers, but they got for the players like Azhari Joseph. But that's not good, I think. So that's a bad thing of the RCB management, I think.
And I want to say one thing about the CSK. Yeah, CSK team is very much good, looking in pen and paper. But for me at least, CSK is suffering from injuries, right? As we know that Devon Conway having injury. I am not sure that he will play entire
As per the reports, Devon Conway has been ruled out from IPL already.
Yes, it is the report, but not confirmed yet by the Chennai Super Kings.
And also, I think Matisse Pathirana will be not available for
few matches. Yeah, so it is what we can say, that it is a bad luck for CSK, but we all believe in Mahendra Singh Dhoni that he will cope up with the team and he will lead the team that much that they will receive the playoffs.
Yes, actually Matisse Pathirana has left injured, so I think the middle overs which bowled last year could be bowled by Shardul Thakur, who already bowled with the Chennai Super Kings last two, three years. So I know we could manage it all. Because Dhoni is there, he will teach him all about it, how to bowl that crucial overs of 11 to 15, that's crucial overs. Because after that, the date overs come. If you manage to score less runs in that over, then it will not affect the team's scores. And it will not affect the batsman to score more, because they have to take the pressure while chasing or while you. So I think this is a good case. If Matisse Pathirana is not available, still CSK will go with Shardul Thakur and also Mukesh Chaudhary, so don't worry about it.
Yes, so our next discussion is about the KKR and the Hyderabad match, right? So when we say about the Hyderabad, we remember about the Hyderabad Biryani, right?
Yes, Hyderabad Biryani,
but Kolkata's biryani is much more better
because it tastes good than Hyderabad Biryani.
Yeah, so let's talk about that, right?
Yes, let's talk about yes.
So the clash between the KKR and SRH is interesting because in the last few matches KKR were really very dominant over Hyderabad, right? Yeah, in the previous season, due to the Harry Brooks 100, KKR faced a loss. But if you see the overall matches between the KKR and Hyderabad, KKR were really very much dominant over Hyderabad, right?
Actually, all the teams of IPL were very dominant against SRH, because you know that Harry Brooks 100 was in the last few matches of Hyderabad, I can remember that. Because the first few games of 7 to 8 games, Hyderabad could win a match, just like Mumbai Indians. Because there was a new team and they could not cope up to the team numbers. Management was not good at that time, and the fact is that they have not a good management because they change captains every year. You can see from our IPL Cup winning captain David Warner, he has been removed from the SRH team because of his bad form. I know his bad form, but he still needs to be supported by the team. So they sold him out. And after that, a big blow, Rashid Khani left the team after that. And you can see that Johnny Bairstow left the team. So you can see that Aidan Markram was the captain of the SRH last year, and they bought for Pat Cummins this year, and they changed the captain. So that's a big deal, because you have the mindset to captain, you have to believe that to the captain. You cannot change captains like this. So changing captains like this cannot win a trophy, no, because players have a mindset of that captain. So what? And they have bought a huge number of players, foreign players. So how to fit in a match? Because we all know that four players are included in a team, in a playing 11. They have got Travis Head, Aidan Markram is there already. Glenn Phillips is there. Marco Jansen, we meet him because he is an all-rounder bowling option.
Henrik Klassen,
there it is. And of course, Pat Cummins, the captain of the team. And Fazlul Farooqi. Many bowlers. So Mohanindu Hasaranga, he must be required because he is the spin department, he will require. And Washington Sundar as a good spinner, already there in the team. I think this team is not balanced because I don't know.
The team is good because
they have good players, but they cannot fit in a match. That's the problem. Because
only four foreign players are allowed, right?
Yes, but how do you, because he needs a bowler, he needs a batsman. So if two batsmen like Travis Head and Aidan Markram goes, then you need the Pat Cummins because he's the captain. So three foreign players and one foreign player have to be Marco Jansen or Glenn Phillips. But I think Marco Jansen will go because he can bowl and bat well. Of course, he can do better bowling than batting, whereas Glenn Phillips can do better batting but less bowling. That's the problem. It's a problem with the team. Whereas the Indian players like batting, Rahul Tripathi is a good player, and Shahbaz Ahmed will be in the middle order, Akash Singh, the new bowler, Umran Malik, of course, the new found of SRH last two years, but his pace is the most important thing, is that he's doing very pace, but he has no swing and no line and length. So that's the problem, because the batsman can hit it very easily, and so he's getting runs. He's getting wickets, but he's also getting runs. And a handy buy of Thangasu Natarajan, because he's a left-arm bowler, which every team requires at the time.
And the main interesting thing is Umran Malik.
Yes.
Who can bowl more than 150 per over, almost he can bowl that two or three balls, right?
Yes, he can
but
bowl.
He doesn't have any speedometer in his hand.
He can bowl 150 per 160 kilometers, but can you think one thing, that if you bowl 160 kilometers, but you have no line or swing on, you have no, but what the batsman can just hit it. Batsman just time it and it will go to a boundary, right? If you bowl in 140 kilometers and if you have swing and pace, and then it will be hard for the batsman to bat now. So first thing is, not pace is the most important thing. You have to use your skills, you have to use the speech, you have to be swing the ball. That's the main thing of the fast bowler can do, because we know the greatest fast bowlers of Shoaib Akhtar, Wasim Akram, they have speed, they already have speed, they'll stay,
yes,
but you can swing also. You can see the swing of Jimmy Anderson. That's the main point. You have to do the swing. That's the main point. SRH have to look. They have to look to the, this point that he needs to have to ball the swing. They have to develop the bowling performance of it.
Yes. And the next thing is, I want to say that about SRH, the management should have to be more responsible, right? Because due to their poor management skills, they are losing enough number of matches.
Yes, they know that they are losing a more amount of money, because they are spending more amount of money, they are playing, buying players. But at last, what happens? They were just poor guys.
Quality always better than quantity, right?
Yes. Because you know, you can look in other teams like Chennai, Delhi, Kolkata, Mumbai.
Yeah. Yeah.
They are not. They have spent less amount of money, but they have got handy buys.
Yes.
They have got good buys. But you can see at Pat Cummins here, 21 crores, just one player. And they have got Travis Head only, but no other players. And they have got only foreign players, which is a problem, because four foreign players, you have to remember that four foreign players is very, very
yeah,
important.
Yeah, actually.
Because,
actually.
And you can also cannot change an impact player to an as a foreigner,
yeah.
Because you have to give it the.
Then, if you want to change, then you have to keep three players, only foreign players, right?
Yes, you have to change it. You have to get three players. That's a very, very important thing. That's the SRH didn't do. They just buy everything, just they spend the money uselessly, I think. So, this is a lot of words buy, I think.
Now, if we come to the KKR team, then I will say the best Indian go batting of the entire IPL, I guess KKR is having that.
Yes.
Mumbai and KKR both have the strongest Indian go batting.
Yes, you can look that they have the best batting Indian lineup, because they have gone for the Indian batsman. That's a good thing. They are uploading the Indian players. That's a good thing, because they have made Ranku Singh. They have again bought Manish Pandey back. They have made Ritesh Rana a star. Shreyas Iyer as the captain. First of all, when you make an Indian player captain, which make a huge impact in the team, because you can see that teams like CSK, Mumbai, KKR, they are making the team Indian captains. That's a good impact, because the team also gets to know that you are believing on the Indian players, you are buying Indian players more. That's a good thing, and they are trying to uproot the Indian players well. I think KKR has the best batting Indian lineup, because if they don't have four foreign players in the team, they can also win the match. But the main point is, if they need to make the bowling lineup strong, I think they can go with the Indian batting lineup with one or two foreigners, and two or three foreigners in the bowling lineup. That will make them very powerful. And that should balance the team, and they can win, and they can compete with any of the teams. That's
we have said about Nitish Rana, Shreyas Iyer, right? Manish Pandey. But we have forgotten about our star, Venkatesh Iyer.
Yes, of course. Venkatesh Iyer is a good opener. We know that he has been blasting in the last two seasons, you know. He's been making 50s all the time in the all matches. He was the villain of 2021 IPL, because he was the only one who scored then.
For him, KKR again came back to the finals, right?
Yes, of course, right.
And then KKR bought Ramandeep Singh from Mumbai Indians. And according to me, he can also be an asset of KKR if KKR retains him in the next year. Because I don't think in this year he will get that much chance. But in the next year, he can be the asset, just like Ringu Singh.
Because in the 2025 auction, as per reports, three players can be retained. So as per news, I think Shreyas Iyer Andre Russell, if he does well in this match, and Rinku Singh will be retained, I think so.
Okay, then they should have retained 3+, right?
Yes.
Then they can buy it in the auction.
Yes, they can buy it in the auction.
Yeah.
But if any teams compete, if they do good performance in this IPL, then other teams will compete in the next auction.
Yes.
So, and or else they can go for other players, like good players are there in the other teams also. You can go for them. That's a good. I must say they have a good auction because they have good auctioners in the team. So with Gautam Gambhir, of course,
yeah,
in the team. Because this year they have made a good auction, probably to the last year. Because last year,
yeah,
their auction was not good.
Not
because they were
up to the moment, yeah,
in the last time they were buying players with this, just buying players of 100k, 1 lakh, erokom.
And I want to say that the middle order of KKR will be the match-changing part. Because the middle order, if you say that the greatest finishers, right, the greatest foreign finisher, Andre Russell, along with Rinku Singh, who can change any match in any time, right? And I will say the weakest point of KKR is the bowling. Obviously, Mitchell Stark have experience and he is also a good bowler, but I don't think that KKR have that much potential or have that much faith in the Indian bowlers. They have to believe in the Indian bowlers, right? Just like Harshit Rana, Vaibhav Arora, Chetan Sakaria. But can they put their that much potential to the game? Can they give their 100% to the game? I have a doubt.
They have to improve from the team because I think this is a good weak bowling lineup. We all know that. We can see that while we were. But
just
if you know that other teams like Mumbai and CSK has also a weak bowling lineup last year. They lost. They were finished in the 9 and 10. But still, with that bowling lineup, they won the match. They won the finals. They won the cup. You can know. With Tushar Deshpande, he was bowling very bad. Still, they won the match. So I think the management will have to look for the way and they have to build the trust on the players. That's a good. Then the players will do their best. If you don't have the trust to the players, then you can perform well because you have to keep that trust with the players.
And I want to say that KKR have the strongest point, right? Because in the bowling, the spin department, KKR is also having one of the best spin department with the impression of Suraj Sharma in the previous year, right?
Yes, Suraj Sharma was good at the previous year because he was doing very well.
Nitish Shana can also bowl the spin.
But Nitish Shana can bowl all the spin well, but he is not, I think,
He's not a pure bowler, but he can take wickets.
He has
already
taken. In the Kolkata pitch, we know he's a spin track. If someone create pressure that when we be the spin track, they can add more spinners because Rashad, we can also bowl spins. They have more spinners, we can bowl.
Interestingly, Nitish Shana also have taken the wickets of big batsmen, right?
Yes.
Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Virat Kohli, he has all the wickets, right? Every De Villiers.
Yes, he can take wicket because in Kolkata match, the point was that the three matches was in a spin track. Of course, the spinners were very handy at that time, so he got wickets. But in the normal, if you go in the Delhi part or in the upper part of Delhi, Mumbai, but he cannot because it's a flat pitch and in Chennai pitch he can also do well. But in that part, it will be the fast bowling pitch, so that will be a problem because he's a spinner. He can do spin pitch and his home ground is in Kolkata, which is a good pitch for spin.
Yeah. So I think KKR is dominant and I think KKR will win the match easily.
Yes.
But no match is much
we cannot
easy.
Say anything because anything can happen in this match because we all know that last time GT was the champions. We all know because everyone celebrated when 2 runs needed of 10 balls. Nobody knew that when Dhoni was out on first ball, no one knew that CSK can win the trophy. But everything can happen. So let's see what happens. Yes.
So let's hope for the best and this is the end of our discussion. So thank you for watching our video till the last. So bye bye.
Subscribe our channel.